We're making some good progress here. A couple episodes ago, we did our refining. As you can see, we got a lot of extra light oil on hand. We're gonna have, in fact, we're topped out our heavy oil, which I kind of suspected we'd do. We got plastic and batteries and lasers going this last episode. I guess I'd kind of promised to do red circuits. That's something we're gonna do this episode and progress into blue science. So I'm just coming up this way to pick up some storage tanks. Let's just pick those guys there. And we're just picking up whatever science we can, just because we can. This is just a mess. Just a mess. We're just going to do ugly spaghetti. How are these guys doing? A couple more light oil. We'll use all that up since we get oil cracking going. So, first thing we need to do is get red circuits going. And red circuits is relatively easy. We reserved this space here for plastic, so we'll take this next section and we will do red circuits. I'm expanding this because I'm gonna, instead of doing these guys, I'm gonna start sticking down lasers. They're just so much easier to down, you know, power. And then move as needed. We can also put a little radar on one of them. So if somebody comes and attacks us down here, we'll be able to see it. Probably also get power. I mean, we have it coming down the side here. We kind of should run it down the middle of our bus. Because if I disconnect any of these, then we keep the power going. Alright, so 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright, so for red circuits, I'm going to use a blueprint that somebody else came up with. It's just a gorgeous little thing for early game red circuits. It looks something like so. And you can tile it. Since we don't have stack inserters, this comes with two stack inserters for the copper cable. And then we're going to do this will be output priority left, as we've been doing all game, deconstruction planner. It just makes it easy. Copy that. There. That way we can easily chain these guys together and get all the red circuits flowing together. Now this is an early build. This isn't going to be a massive amount of red circuits. But because for one, you can't get any beacons in here. But for early game, you just want to get some red circuits flowing. And this is definitely a beautiful, beautiful design. As you can see, our power is fluctuating. Like, we're not having enough to power lasers. And these guys are already chewing on mega lasers. Look at this. Suckers. Let's pull this up. Let's put down a big guy for a corner. And let's put the radar out a little bit. Alright, so obviously we're gonna need copper. Let's come back here looking for copper. Plastic and green circuits. So let's do that. Puts it on the left. We want it on the top. My brain working for this. Why is my brain not working? Work, work, work. Do this all the time. So if you want it on the left, of course, see, that's what I was trying to do. And if you want it on the right, that's what you want it to, but I'm trying to float down. I don't think I have any examples of that yet. Actually, I do right here. There we go. There we go. Let me do that. This one's easy. Ah, crap. Stop. I don't want copper on that. Plastic on that. I don't want that copper. first one. And I don't know why there's a little gap here, why there's an underground in this blueprint for that spot. I don't get it, but I didn't come up with this thing. And I call it the red circuit flower. That's not that building. Let's have a bot wandering around or something. As you can see, we got red circuits falling. It's kind of a really funky design. But you can't put beacons on it. So, I mean, you can do, you know, say, speed circuits in or module in them, but it's somewhere in here. Where did we have red chips there? So where is our chips flown in right here? So we need them to flow in on the left side, which is fairly easy when you're coming from the left. Off here. Four lanes of pipes. Which one's that? The second one. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. That's what's off right there. What we can do. So where that needs to be. Okay, I guess. Oh, we are off a lane. No, we're not. We're not. No, we're not. Let's do that now. Right there, let's upgrade. So, red chips it is. Finally do our stack inserter. this. It's not the pretty thing we thought it was. Do that though. So we can now do, let's do our chess. Let's make that a little easier. Speed it through there. I'm probably gonna need to change the elements to. Second, we don't need to switch. And my alarm's about to go off. Let's not have that sounding. This is where we're going to get off the computer here in 25 minutes. Chest still. Don't have a few things we don't want to be carrying all the time anyways. Those. Don't need to add that to our so we got red chips. Blue science. Now, I have a build. It's not really part of my book. I just added it. It's from another as you can see, it's a pretty insane build. It was to do a certain percentage of science per minute. What I like about it most is it's modular. If we go, with a normal build, you can't really expand this. You got a couple electric miners, you got some engines, but if you want to go to expand this, there's no way to do so, and there's no room for beacons. So, what we need to do, kind of first, let's bring up some power poles. Let's get some lasers out here. I kind of need to move this out a ways. We're going to do such a big build. And look nice just to be able to deke. It's going to kind of hammer on our electric bill. love how easy it is to expand your base with lasers. Literally, we just took over a whole ton of territory. How are we doing on large power poles? It's kind of the backbone to this. Could we be researching just kind of anything? Now this is still probably not enough room, but it gives us some freedom to play with it. Alright, so to build this, we're gonna need we need a ton of engines, and to support engines we need pipes and gears really, right? It's like blue sciences, engines, electric binding drill, and then red circuits we're building elsewhere. So what we need is a big line for engines and kind of another line for electric mining drills. The engines we can use towards purple science if we do this right. So, to produce, the engines, I need steel, which we're building elsewhere, gears, and pipes. Pipes are super easy. It says two pipes, but you can make them, they're at half second each. And then gears are also half second, but they require two iron. So it's, as you can see, it's four iron and one steel to make one of these guys. Not terribly expensive. They just require a ton of iron. So to do this, we're going to need a whole lot more assembly machines than the five I'm carrying. We could probably use some more. I was playing while on vacation. That's a truck going by. I guess I really need to address that copper. So we're not really probably going to get to blue science. How am I doing on electric miners? Got a few. Yeah, we could use. Oh, inventory full. Who's using copper up here I can get rid of? Bangs and died. And no radar up there, I can't tell what. Toss that in some grenades. Speaking of grenades. Whoa, we don't need to be creating that many. Bullets, how are we doing here? We don't need so many of these either. Let's stop that at there. So, power fluctuating because lasers are firing. Look at that, 42 megawatts. We're really going to need to work on solar soon. We can't until we get blue science going, and we can't do that until we get more. Time to get some more copper going. Factorio, the wonderful habit trail for humans. So we're also having a little iron crunch. Fortunately for us, that is a very easy fix. Just pick up some iron. Just a moment. Let's stick you in there. Alright, so copper. I kind of need to do something similar. Probably have two lanes between these. Whoops. Even though it looks kind of pretty. I mean, it was pretty to do more when you got two lanes between stuff than you when you only have one. Oops. So priority left. So we can use our copper. We don't have a whole ton of undergrounds. So I guess we don't need to use undergrounds. here. How is that helping? It's probably going to max out, but until we really max this out, probably should have set that as a priority input over there. Those rows first. Alright, so this is backed up. And do the same thing there, so it flows from the right side first. So it uses up this patch first. So we just added a whole bunch of new miners, so that's hitting power. Can we create a whole bunch of these? How much more room do we have? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. So we can do 8 and 16. We got 4 boilers already made. That'd be 14, 15, 16. And then 32 of these guys. 17, we need a whole ton of iron. What did I say? 32, so 15 more. I'm not quite sure we have room for all this. This track going through here. That Okay, we'll just slap this down. That's only six. 1, 2, 3. Hold on a second. There we go. No, we don't. We need 8 yells. 5, 6, 7, 8. The burner inserters have a difficult time grabbing from faster belts. Since we have the slow belts. We can skip them by doing something like that. We can set priority output right on those, so they actually will prefer to choose the we just need the spline of coal. I just burned all my power poles, didn't I? And I don't have any wood on me. Solve that. All right, what can be researched? Landmines. So that should be 22, 4. 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. All right, so each pump can support 20 of these guys. That's all backed up. But if this was flowing, you know, lots of lasers firing, that's basically what we're trying to say. You guys do it on bullets. Doesn't seem like anything else I can research. Of course I'm wrong. All sorts of things I can research. Alright, well, seems like we fixed power for the time being. This is only a short-term solution. We're going to quickly need more power than 80 megawatts. But I have to take off now. And we shall pick up next time and work on blue science. I'm Dune. Thanks for watching. It's another episode of Factorio Megabase version 2. We're starting from the beginning. We're working our way up. And we're going to have lots of fun building this thing out. So, stay tuned. Follow me on Twitch, subscribe on YouTube. If you miss any episodes, they will be on YouTube. Thanks once again, and we'll catch you later.